What's up, everyone? It's Asaglo here. So let's talk about the season 2 launch trailer for Killer Instinct. So it just went up on YouTube and they showed us a couple of things that we've kind of already knew were in season 2, but they did actually hint on new and returning characters. Now there's only a few things they mentioned before the characters, and that was like a new revamped online, there's new game modes and enhanced graphics. But I'm really more curious about the new characters and the returning characters. Like, for example, this dude right here. So, looking at this character's build, it resembles the character that was teased at the end of the Maya trailer back during the Tokyo Game Show event. So, half the community is calling this Mummy, and the other half is calling it not a mummy. So, for this character, I gotta say, it does look like that one during the trailer. So, let's move on. So the next one in the trailer was this gigantic rock looking creature. Now this looks like something straight out of Lord of the Rings. That's all I'm saying. Is this guy a grappler? It's hard to tell. He could be like maybe just a heavily armored slow character that hits really hard. I don't really know, but you know, Killer Instinct has always had really odd looking characters. So I'd say, you know, a rock looking creature kind of fits in just well with an Iceman, a werewolf, a ninja, a robot, and a guy who's on fire. So the next character here seems to be holding a spear with a blade on it. Now at first I thought, could it be Kim Woo? But then I realized, well, it could just be a random warrior with a spear and a blade on it. But one thing we have not seen in any version of Killer Instinct was a character who had a long range weapon for long range pokes, similar to how you saw Killick from the Soul Calibur series. So the next one is a dead giveaway. Okay, it's a dinosaur. It's Riptor, okay? So Riptor was one of the original Killer Instinct characters that was highly requested amongst the community. So it's good to see this character return at least in some form. So hopefully this character does turn out to be really well so we can enjoy the classic Riptor with some new additions. So let's move on. Alright, so the next one here, I gotta say, looks like Shadow Jago. Now there's three reasons why I say this. The first one is the build looks like Jago. The second reason is because the position of his fingers on his left hand. Now if you fought Shadow Jago in arcade mode before, right before his introduction, on the versus screen, he'd appear as a black silhouette and have a new stance different than Jago. And if you looked at his left hand, he would position his fingers in a similar way as this silhouette. Now the third reason why I say this could be Shadow Jago is if you look on his right arm, it looks like he has a pad or an armor over his forearm. And this is what Jago has, and so does Shadow Jago. So if that does turn out to be Shadow Jago, then I'm just wondering what they're doing with his moves. Are they going to give him all of Jago and Shadow Jago's moves combined, or take away some of Jago's moves and just keep some of the new ones that Shadow Jago had? I guess we'll see. So the last one, it's a pretty big giveaway. Yeah, it's not too hard to figure out which one this is. So this is Cinder. However, it looks like his body is a lot more slender and possibly his right arm is more deformed or mutated. This could be a result of the Ultratech experiments on him. I don't know. Or this just could be maybe the art for his silhouette. Maybe he'll appear a little bit differently in the final version. But that's good that Cinder has come back because he was a highly requested character from the community. And it's a good thing that Iron Galaxy did not let us down. Now, some people in the community are a little bit let down because I guess they were expecting footage on the new characters that we haven't seen yet. But the developers actually promised that the trailer will only reveal upcoming characters in Season 2. It won't show gameplay. So they pretty much delivered what they promised, so I think the trailer is just fine. Now one thing I did notice is on this screen here, you see all 8 characters. And I thought Season 2 would only have 8 characters, but if it's true, there's a 9th character and that possibly could be Aria. Now just judging by the build of the portrait, it does match Aria's build, but then again, it could just be a random portrait just used for the 9th hidden character. I guess we'll see later on. So at the end of the trailer, they did show the stage ultra for TJ Combo stage. It looked pretty cool, and I know Maya stage has one already because during the videos that were coming up around the Tokyo Game Show event, they did in fact show the command list and it had a stage ultra input for Maya stage. However, I still would have preferred at least one ultimate combo per character instead of stage ultras. But what do you guys think about the trailer so far and all the news we got? So let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and I'll see you guys later on. And don't forget, subscribe to my channel for daily gaming videos and lots more Killer Instinct footage. So our next video is where I set a world record win streak in Killer Instinct 2 online ranked matches. So check out the video by clicking the annotation over the logo, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.